I'll define academics through a dictionary definition. There are two definitions of academic. First definition of academic is of or relating to education or scholarship. The second one is of only theoretical interest and no practical value. So those are the two definitions of academic. And I think that we oftentimes have a pedagogy that advocates for definition two and goals of definition one. And you can't get to definition one unless you change definition two. So good academic spaces are related to the humanity of the young folks and the experiences of the young folks and they are doing. And the goal is to have them form a relationship to the content. I mean, that's the goal of any good teaching. Art class or science class, science or math. The goal of the educator is to create an environment where young folks form a relationship to the content that is so strong that they want to pursue that discipline at the highest levels. Also, high expectations are a part of love. And high expectations and high academic rigor is a function of love. I always tell my students, I love and believe in you. That's why I expect you to do more. And the idea that relationship building and care for young folks cannot happen concurrently with high expectations is such a fallacy. You know, it's a tough question to ask sometimes. I'm like, what makes you think that those things are opposite? I care about them. Of course I want them to be excellent. High academic expectations is just criticality. Like, I'm going to be critical of what you present because I know that you have the potential to be and do better. It's about high expectations, high rigor, and then good love that creates the passion for the discipline so they can meet those benchmarks.